Today we'll be summarizing the film Requiem for a Dream, directed by Darren Aronofsky and released in 2000. Of course, this video contains major spoilers about the film. Let's start. The film starts with an episode of the TV show Tappy. A mother, Sarah, is arguing with her son Harry. Sarah locks herself in a closet and gives her son a key, which will be used by Harry to unchain the TV and to bring it outside to sell it to fuel his drug addiction. The mother, still locked inside her room, tells herself that everything will be fine. The son and his friend Tyrone carry the TV through the town to go and sell it. They arrive at the flea market and sell the TV to an old man. Then they do some drugs and dance to techno music. Afterward, they go to eat something and plan on getting into drug dealing. While they're eating, a cop sits next to them. Harry dreams about stealing the gun from the policeman's holster. Then the shop owner wakes the protagonist up, and we realize that what just happened was nothing but a fantasy. The two friends then leave. Sarah goes to the flea market and gets her TV back. The old man advises her to tell the police about what her son is doing, but she refuses. She then goes back home and sits in front of the TV, eating some chocolates. Harry and his girlfriend Marion ring an apartment intercom and get inside by fooling one of the residents. In the meantime, Harry's mother is still watching the TV and receives a call telling her that she's won the opportunity to participate in a television show. She gets out an old red dress she wore at her son's graduation ceremony and tries it on, but it doesn't fit. Harry and Marion talk about her parents and how they left her down. They dream about opening a clothes shop and hug. Sarah tells her neighbor that she got invited on TV. She tries to put the red dress on again with her friend, but it still won't fit. The friend then tells her that she's got a lovely diet book that she can take and read. Harry and Marion go back inside the apartment complex and she pulls a wire, making an alarm go off. They run away and kiss in the elevator. Sarah sits in front of the TV again, reading through her friend's diet book, but finds it hard to follow due to the harsh limits on sugar and dressings. Harry and Marion are sleeping on a couch in a derelict apartment. The mother, in the meanwhile, is getting her hair dyed by her neighbor. Harry, Tyrone, and Marion take some pills, smoke, play music around in their apartment, and invite some people over. The mother and her friend argue about how the dyed hair looks orange and not red. Harry and Marion have some private time and dream about opening up a clothes shop together. The mother is eating breakfast and trying to follow her diet. She eats half an orange, a coffee, and a hard-boiled egg, but is still hungry. Obsessed with food, Sarah tries to go out and get some sunlight with her lady friends to take her mind off things. Everybody jokes around, and one of the ladies mentions that her daughter got thin quickly by taking some pills the doctor prescribed her. The mailman then arrives with a letter for Sarah. In the meantime, Tyrone and Harry go out to buy drugs to sell. Harry is passing time by listening to music and taking drugs while he waits for Tyrone to be back with the drugs that they'll be selling. When he finally gets back, they agree on trying the newly bought drugs and get intoxicated. Sarah is watching TV again and starts to think about food again. To avoid giving in to her hunger, she goes to bed but can't stop thinking about sweets. In desperation, she calls Rosie, her friend, and asks her for the doctor's number. Harry is talking to Marion, who needs to go out on a date with another man named Arnold, since he might say to her parents that she discontinued therapy. Harry is visibly jealous, but they still embrace and laugh, and he lets her go, warning her not to do anything stupid. Marion then goes out to dinner with Arnold. They speak about the fact that his wife is now in Florida. Harry's mother is now in the doctor's office. The doctor tells her that she's overweight and assures her that she'll lose all the weight she wants to. Harry and Tyrone go around dealing drugs while Marion stays home and draws clothes. They continue dealing drugs and make more money each day. After sorting out her pills, Sarah prepares some breakfast and then erratically goes around her apartment, dancing and repeatedly sitting down to watch the TV, only to get up again. Tyrone, while his girlfriend waits naked on his bed, thinks about his childhood. Harry and his girlfriend sit on the rocks by the sea and talk about Harry's mother. Harry decided to buy her a new TV, but first, they take some drugs. Sarah is getting progressively more confused and absent-minded due to her pills, but continues to do her things and spends a lot of time watching TV. While she's out with her friends, Sarah sees Harry, brings him in, and offers him some breakfast. They sit down and start talking. Harry lies about his job, but tells his mother that he has a girlfriend and that he's sorry about how he treated her in the past and that he got her a new TV as a gift. Harry then, by observing his mother grinding her teeth, understands what's making her so erratic. Her amphetamines-filled diet pills. They argue, and he warns her about the pills. Harry then gets to know that she's on a diet because she's been invited to appear on a TV show. She tells him that the prospect of being on TV is the only thing that makes her get up in the morning. Harry, upset and saddened, tells his mother that he'll visit her more often and leaves. On his way home in a taxi, Harry cries, but is unable to do anything to stop his mother from becoming an amphetamines addict. Tyrone is talking to a mute gang leader, who tells him he can make him become something more than what he is now. The meeting gets cut short by an ambush, where the gang leader gets killed, and Tyrone is arrested by the police. Sarah has been completely turned numb by her pills. Harry and Marion lay on top of Marion's drawings, talking. Harry's friend Tyrone is still in jail. Sarah calls the doctor because she thinks the pills that he gave her are less powerful than the ones she first started to take, but she gets told that she's just developing a tolerance to them. In frustration, she takes two instead of the prescribed one and has a psychotic episode. She sees herself on TV and her fridge starts to shake. Tyrone is bailed out of prison by one of his associates, who tells him about the gang war that just started between the Italians and the blacks. Due to this war, drugs are impossible to deal, meaning that Tyrone, Harry, and Marion will lose a lot of money. While walking down the street, they see two Italian gangsters stuffing a body inside a trash can and run away. Things are getting harsher for every character. Sarah is about to overdose on her pills, but fortunately survives the night. Harry and Marion are sleeping together, but she suddenly wakes up due to her drug withdrawal. Sarah goes to the doctor's office in the morning, but is completely fazed by the amphetamines. She's confused, but her doctor won't listen to her and gives her just a small piece of paper, telling her to come next week. Harry and Marion fight because they're completely out of money and drugs. Later in the evening, Harry and Tyrone go smoking on the beach, and Tyrone tells Harry that the drug prices have doubled, and they need to start cutting their drugs by a lot more. Harry goes back to Marion and begs her to call Arnold for some money. She tells him that Arnold will give her the money, but she doesn't know what she'll have to do. Marion goes out on a date with Arnold. She fantasizes about stabbing him with a fork, but is forced instead to tell him that she needs money and goes to bed with him. Harry is still back at his apartment, suffering from withdrawal. Marion leaves Arnold's house and throws up outside. She gets back to her apartment and sits down on the sofa with Harry. Tyrone sits on his bed, dreaming about his girlfriend. Sarah dances alone in her apartment with grotesque makeup on her face. Harry and Tyrone go out to buy some drugs to sell, while Marion is still in her apartment, rummaging through all their stuff, trying to find something to placate her addiction. The drug deal goes bad, and shots are fired, leading to Harry and Tyrone leaving without buying anything. Sarah continues to take more and more pills, which only worsen her psychosis. She sees her fridge moving on its own. Harry and Marion fight again because of the failed drug deal. Tyrone and Harry decide to go to Florida. Sarah, after taking more pills to calm down, sees herself on TV again, and her psychosis is about to reach its climax. Her fridge starts to roar like a wild beast, and her TV self and Tappy teleport inside Sarah's apartment and laugh at her and her broken-down furniture. She hallucinates a TV crew moving all her stuff around and pointing cameras at her face. All the people from the TV dance and jump around a frightened and confused Sarah. Her fridge jumps towards her and growls. Everybody shouts, "Feed me, Sarah," while she screams and cries. Her fridge reveals a giant bloody mouth, and Sarah finally runs away into the snowy streets. Harry and Tyrone are still driving down to Florida. Sarah boards a train and makes her way towards Madison Avenue because she wants to talk to the TV agency. Marion calls Angel, one of Harry's regular contacts, and breaks down in desperation, asking for help. Angel then tells her that Big Tim might help her for something in return and gives her his number. Sarah finally arrives at the TV agency offices and begs everybody to tell her when she'll be on television. The paramedics get called and they bring her away. Marion, in desperation, calls Big Tim's number. Harry discovers an infection in his arm from one of his drug needles, but injects some heroin there nonetheless. Marion meets Little John and performs fellatio on him for money. Sarah is still getting treated in the hospital. Marion, after selling her body away, takes a bath and screams underwater in shock. Harry's arm is getting worse and goes to the hospital with Tyrone. Two medics force-feed Sarah some food, but she regurgitates everything. Tyrone, while waiting for Harry in the waiting room, gets arrested. Harry gets arrested as well. Marion gets ready to attend an orgy organized by Big Tim and receives a phone call from Harry. She asks him if he can come back today, and he says yes, but that's impossible. Harry and Tyrone are locked up in prison. Marion goes to the orgy and is greeted by Little John. Sarah agrees to undergo some alternative treatments. While every inmate goes through a health inspection, Harry fails to hide his arm and screams in pain. Sarah gets electrically shocked as part of her treatment. Marion is forced to partake in some sick sexual practices during the orgy. All is getting only worse for every character in the movie. Harry gets his arm amputated. He dreams about Marion and he wakes up in tears with his arm gone. Two of Sarah's friends visit her after she received her treatment. Outside, they break down in tears. Marion, now back at her apartment after the orgy, hugs a drug packet. Tyrone dreams of his childhood while trying to sleep in jail. Sarah dreams of being happy, on TV, with her son. The film ends. Thank you for watching. Be sure to subscribe, like, and hit that bell icon, as it really does help this channel a lot. Be safe, and have a great day.